Okay, Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Azhar bin Muhammad Aziz, number matrix CD190229. Okay, I will explain about the introduction. Okay, the numerical method of ODE can also be extended to solve PDE. The method discussed for handling initial value problems can be used for parabolic equation and hyperbolic equation. Similarly, the method already discussed for dealing with BVB can be used to solve elliptic partial differential equation that are also boundary value problem. However, the extension of the method for solving PDE is not simple. The purpose of this concrete example that we have chosen to enrich the understanding of the cost in numerical method in order to increase the accessibility of the concept and how to step counter and solve the problem. As a draft case, there is 5 examples that we have found in real life, but we have chosen one case to study, which is to determine a different material and component choice that has been used in each week using Gauss-Seidel method. Okay, this is the 5 real application in real life that we have been choose. Firstly, making weather prediction. Second, price estimation by airline companies. Number 3 is machine learning. Number 4 is determine a different material and component choice that has been used in each week using Gauss-Seidel method. And number 5 is interpolation to estimate the number of student marks in the school. Okay, our objective is to determine a different material and component choice that has been used in each week using Gauss-Seidel method. Okay, objective number 2 is to apply the relation of Gauss-Seidel method in our daily life. And number 3 is to apply appropriate solution of numerical method using mathematical software, which is FreeMAT. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum dan selamat sejahtera. My name is Muhammad Irfan Razik, matrix number AD190010. And I will explain about Gauss-Seidel iteration methodology. Gauss-Seidel iteration method is used to solve linear system equation with unknown variables. And this method is named after German scientists Carl Friedrich Gauss and Philipp Ludwig Seidel. Gauss-Seidel method allows user to control runoff error. Iterative methods used to solve the solution obtained by direct methods. And iterative methods reduce the number of iterations. There are 4 basic procedures for Gauss-Seidel method. First is we need to algebraically solve each linear equation for x. And we need to assume an initial guess solution array. After that, we need to solve for each x and repeat. And lastly, we need to use absolute relative approximate error after each iteration to check if error is within pre-specified tolerance. It depends on the questions. These are the Gauss-Seidel iteration algorithm, and we consider the n equation and also as unknown variables. We can also rearrange this into matrix arrangement like here A. But first we need to make sure that the matrix A is diagonally dominant. Okay, to make sure it's diagonally dominant, we need to check the row here. Number, we can see that the value is 3, negative 5, negative 7 and negative 9. And we can rearrange here and see that the value is from high to low. So it is diagonally dominant for matrix A. These are the formula for Gauss-Seidel iteration formula. And we need to insert the value here. And the value that we got here, we need to put it in the table. And we need to repeat the iteration at the table until the stopping boundaries. And then we will get the answers.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Ashraf bin Muhammad Nur, CD190251. So I will continue our presentation about problem statement. In designing a product or item for use human being, the human factor is an important element that must be emphasized. We may use the Gauss Seidel method to take a systematic approach to find toys that have been used in each week in different materials. The planning process is extremely beneficial in determining project goals and security needs. We are created and constructed in variety of components, gender, types and material, for example. The following are issues that can be identified in today's toy design. The first one is how many toys that have been used in each week. Does the toy suitable or valid? Does the toy ergonomic? Does the material chosen to construct the toys acceptable for all gender? The next one, does the toys safe to use daily? Is it possible to use the toy for a long period without them become unusable? The next one, does the Gauss Seidel method suitable to determine the material? Does the Gauss Seidel method give the solution? Next one, is possible to get the material and component from the Gauss Seidel method? And the last one is, how many material and component that have been used in a week to produce the toys? So that's all for me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Zafani Ahmad Azri, bit matrix number 8190086, and I'm going to discuss about calculation and also results. So a toy factory can manufacture toys in a large number really. But in order to get the optimal number of toys that can be manufactured weekly, calculation must be done by an industrial engineer. Material needed for one production of toys can be seen here. So as you can see in the table, for one toys for boys, which is it needed 0.8 kg of spandex, 1.3 kg of cotton, and 0.3 wool. So these are the requirements needed for one. So the supply for each week will rise as time goes on, and as you can see, for this week the supply for this week is only 1400 kg of spandex, 1100 kg of cotton, and 1300 kg of wool for production of toys. So from the table, the data can be turned into simultaneous equation and then can be converted into matrix form. As you can see, the 0.3 is for spandex and 1.1 is for cotton and 0.9 is for wool. So as you can see, this is the simultaneous equation. The x1 is actually the number of toys for boys, and x2 is the normal toys for girls, and x3 is the unisexual toys. So we can turn the data and can be converted into simultaneous equation, and then the simultaneous equation we can turn into matrix form. So one of the reasons we want to turn the simultaneous equation into matrix form so that we can use the Gauss Seidel iteration method. So in order to use Gauss Seidel iteration method, the first thing we need to consider is we need to check whether the matrix has already in its dominant form or not. So as you can see here, the matrix is not in diagonally dominant. So in order for us to turn the matrix into diagonally dominant, there are three steps that we need to consider, which is shown here, which is, you can see here, bracket 1.3 bigger and equal than 0.9 plus 0.5, and that is for the first row, and the second row, which is 1.1, and the third row, which is 1.4. so as you can see here, all the three requirement has already been fulfilled. So this shows that the matrix is already in diagonally dominant. So the next step is really simple. What we need to do is just input our data and also fill in our data into the equation of Gaussian iteration method. So I have already, as you can see here, x1 to the power of k plus 1 is equals to 1100 minus 0.7 times x2 minus 0.5 times x3 divided by 1.3. So that is for x1, and x2 and sk can be seen here. So we already put our information and fulfill the equation. The next step we have to do is simply just making a table so that it is much more organized. And as you can see, we iterate it until 14 iteration because we consider error at 0.005. So from here, we know that x1 is equals to 331.9012, x2 is 430.41, x3 is 734.4755. Thus, the number of toys that can be made in 1 week are 331 toys for boys, 430 for girls, and 734 for unisexual toys. So, in order for us to confirm the answer, one thing we can do is by using PMAT software. And as you can see here, there is a Gaussian iteration method code, and after I check it, the answer is still the same. We put the max iteration at 20 and our error is at 0.005, and we will get the same answer, which is 331.9012, 430.41, and 734.474 unisexual toys. So that's all for me. Thank you very much for lending your ears.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and good morning. My name is Muhammad Al-Bukhari bin Hazmi. My metric number CD190063. Today I want to talk about the discussion for our project. Our purpose in the applied method that we study to solve and systematic approach to find toys that have been used in each week in different materials. We have using Gauss-Seidel method allowed by chapter 3 to determine a solution to a linear system with variable z1, z2 until zn. By begin with a Gauss at the solution and then repeatedly substitute value for z1, z2 until z2 into a system equation to get a new value if the system for z2, z2 until zn ultimately stabilizes. That approach are effective, resulting in a real solution. So moreover, the linear equation can be found out of our data of the project. The data may be transformed into a stimulus equation and subsequently into a metric form. Next, because the equation is not linearly dominant, we make some change to information of the matrix. Furthermore, from the table, the iteration stop at 40 iteration, and we to the consider error at 0.005, and then the value for z1, z2, and z3. The result get number of toys can be made in 1 week are 331 for boys, 430 for a girl, and 730 toys for unisex. So in addition, the calculation can be verified by using free math, because this is a easier to way to let calculation and analysis data more accurate and convenient. So we go to conclusion for our project. In conclusion, our objective for this project achieve the final equation form and generate by some using Gauss-Seidel method and apply appropriate solution for numerical method using mathematics software FreeMath. Basic procedure for Gauss-Seidel method are algebraically solve each linear equation for z1, assume an initial Gauss solution array, solve for each z1 and repeat, and use absolute relative approximations error after each iteration to check its error is within pre-certificate tolerance. Although the past research work suggests a method of using Jacob method. However, we managed to use Gauss-Seidel method to solve this problem. Both of the method easy to use, but Gauss-Seidel method gives more accurate step-by-step solution. Hopefully, this tip can improve the interest and accuracy in linear system equation. Also, it is useful in for analysis in part generation perform of the mechanism which further help to augment the pieces requirement for the industry.